Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Prakriti Varshne, a solo traveler and a mountaineer. Let's take you to the second mountain on the list of 12 mountains this year. Welcome to Uganda. A land of stunning natural beauty and home to one of the highest peaks of Africa, Mount Stanley. It is located in Rwenzori National Park. I started my journey from Nairobi in Kenya. After I summited Mount Kenya, I took a flight from Nairobi to Entebbe in Uganda. From there, I met a friend, Rukaya, who is from Tanzania, and surprisingly, we connected on Instagram and planned to climb the mountain. From there, we took a taxi of about 8 hours, I think 9 hours, to this town called Kasese, which is also a starting point for trekking in Rwenzori Mountains. So Kasese is a small little village, I would say, or a town, and I found it super cute and old school. So we started our hike of 7 days to make it to the top of third highest peak in Africa through thick jungles, boardwalk, uphill climbs, rocky terrain, glacier and whatnot. The route we took looked somewhere like this, and I drew it when I was just, you know, I was climbing it. So the first day we started from the gate to Nyabiata camps, and we took about 2.5 hours to reach there.
Day one started from around 1600 meters above sea level. We'll be going till 2600 meters. And the view is like this.
This is the last river for today, so we shall cross the Mubuku River tomorrow.
Okay. We're for about 4 kilometers. And we have a resting point here. So made it to camp 1. There's a hut where we can sleep.
Day 2 was quite uphill, and we took about 5 hours to make it to the next camp called Jone Mate.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
I'm ready.
And you?
Yes, I'm ready.
No, you don't look.
I'm ready to go to Jone Mate right now.
Oh yeah?
With you.
Let's go. What is that?
Luberia Gibroa.
Okay.
And it is our cultural medicine for the younger ladies.
Okay.
When you be giving water through the, this one, it has a pipe.
Uh-huh.
When you pass the water from this pipe and you keep on give to the young lady, they shall give birth very smoothly without being operated.
Bujuku and?
Bujuku and Mubuku.
Okay. So these are the kind of rest points they have here in the Rwenzori Mountains. So we made it in 6.5 hours. I think which was possible in 3. That's, tell me your name. I forgot again. Tell me your name again.
Isaiah.
I keep forgetting your name. But we made it.
Yeah.
Day 3 was a really challenging one because we went through a lot of muddy patches and a lot of boardwalk, which takes a lot of concentration, and we took about 5 hours again to reach Buzuku camp at about 3500 meters above sea level.
Day 3, we are very much ready. I slept so well last night. It's a little cold, but good to go. And we'll be going to Buzuku camp today, which is around 3900 meters. It's gonna be so much fun. Good morning.
Morning.
Are you excited?
Why? Why are you so excited?
I don't know, I am. There's the glacier for Stanley, and that's the peak that we are gonna climb. I am ready for day 3. It's gonna be a long day or a lot of hard work, but we are ready. Okay, so walking on board looks easy and beautiful, but it's not. You have to concentrate a lot. Another boardwalk?
Yes, that is the upper boardwalk.
Okay.
Yes.
Another boardwalk. I don't like it. So beautiful. You can see the peak from here. That. Tell me,
Buzuku camp.
Okay. Oh no, we are at Buzuku Lake.
Yes, but you're big.
What happens when you trek in? I'm sorry. Camp.
Welcome to Buzuku camp.
My name?
Patrick. Nature.
Day 4 is the most challenging because we went through a lot of mud patches, and then it was like super uphill climb, and it had a lot of rocks to cross as well. So we took about 4 to 5 hours again to reach Alena Hut.
So it's day 4, we are going to around 4300 meters, and it's so windy and cold. We will be in about 10 minutes, and yeah, I can't wait for the summit, you know. Okay. Are you excited?
Yes, I'm excited.
I'm in the middle. I didn't even ask the question yet. This is a gem led by Rukaya. And we have made it!
Yes!
Woohoo! And somewhere around
is Margarita Peak.
This is our network point.
That's the view. Day 5, we woke up around 1 a.m. and left for the summit push. We went in the dark, took our torches and crampons to walk on the glacier. We took about, I think, 6 to 7 hours through rocky and glacial terrain. And when we reached the top, it was snowing and we couldn't see anything, but it was beautiful. I was so proud of myself that I did the second summit in Africa.
How many times have you done this? You have lost the count?
Yes.
Thank you. Finally made it! It's our first semi-technical event.
Yes, first
and she did a great job.
Thanks.
To another mountain.
So we quickly took our pictures and decided to return to Elena Hut, which was again like this. It was full descent over the glacier.
So we don't record anything,
and a lot of rocks. We took about, I think, 2.5 hours to make it to Elena Hut.
Africa ka second mountain khatam, and we'll be doing third mountain in about a week.
So we took our lunches and started walking again towards this next camp called Kitandhara, which is at around 3900 meters and took us about 2 hours.
So we are going back.
Day 6, we walked for 3 hours again. It was super, like, full descent and a lot of stairs, a lot of board, a lot of mud patches, and but it was really beautiful, and it was the last camp before we were headed to the base.
Well, this is probably the last day that we've been walking, and I chose to walk fast, and while it was supposed to take 6 hours, we are doing it in 3.
Day 7, we were really exhausted. We just walked like zombies. Took about, what I think, 4 hours to make it to the gate and just head home, take a shower. This mountain was so different than what I've done so far because of the muddy patches, the boardwalk, the long walks every day. It was just like so different, but worth every second. That's why I think I really want to climb mountains in different regions and different countries, so I get to understand the culture, I get to understand how mountain people are and how different mountains are. Being in Uganda was a really beautiful journey I will never forget. Thanks to all the guides, all the porters and the trekking agency I was climbing with for making it worthwhile, and I shall see you next time very soon.
My mother still remains with me, you know, for 60 days. Maybe he's going out to stalk with the other.
Thank you, Mr. Anzai.
I will drop down the cost of this expedition, the flight and visa, and I will also link down the company I went with, and you guys can check out. And if you have any questions, you can drop down in the comment section below and I will try to reply as soon as possible. Couple of things that you should keep in mind when you are in Uganda and climbing. So ATM don't always work, so you've got to have local currency. Plus, if you have dollars, you have to keep in mind that they are 2010 and above. They cannot be less than that, because otherwise half of the time they will not take it. If you are trekking in Ranzori, please have your gumboots ready, because there are really big muddy patches and it can be really daunting at times. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I add value in your life some or the other way. Until next time, until next climb, keep wandering, keep wandering. Bye.